This is the solution to quiz 12. Okay. So the first thing to do is we need to find the critical points. As a reminder, there's two kinds of critical points. One kind of critical point on a surface is when you have a pointy place, like this point. So here there's no tangent. That pointy place, because the surface does not become flat at any scale. And the other kind of critical point is when there is a tangent and that tangent is horizontal. So those are the two kinds of critical points. This means that the x partial or the y partial is undefined. That's what lack of a tangency means in our case, and the horizontal tangency means that fx, the x partial, and fy are both 0. So those are the two different kinds of critical point. In either case, we're going to need to consider the partials. So the x partial is 2x minus 4y minus 20. 2x minus 4y minus 20. Good. And then the y partial is negative 4x plus y. Negative 4x. Plus y. Plus 12. These are always defined. Those are always defined, and therefore all critical points are this kind of critical point. Okay, so we want to solve the system 2x minus 4y minus 20 is 0. That is to say that the x partial is 0 at the same time as negative 4y, not negative 4x, plus y plus 12 is equal to 0. So I'll refer to these as equations 1 and 2. Okay, so I'll start with equation 2. So from equation 2, I can solve for y and obtain that y is equal to 4x minus 12. Moving all of the, moving the 4x to the other side and the 12 to the other side. So now I'll put that into equation 1. Put this into equation 1 to obtain 2x minus 4y, but I'll use 4x minus 12 for that y, and then minus 20 is 0. So 2x minus 16x plus 48 minus 20 is 0. So negative 14x and then plus 28 is 0. So then 28 is 14x. So 2 is x. So now we can take this and put that into, so I'll call this one here equation 3. If we put that into equation 3, this information that equation, we obtain that y is 4x, but x is 2, so 4 times 2 minus 12, so that is 8 minus 12 is negative 4, and therefore the point 2, negative 4 is the only critical point. Okay, so now we're going to classify this with the second partials test. Well, we'll need all the second partials. So the xx partial, that means x partial of x partial, is 2. The yy partial, which means y partial of y partial, is 1. The xy partial, which means y partial of x partial, so x partial, so that's negative 4. And then the yx partial, which means x partial of y partial, is also negative 4. So the mixed partials are the same. So that's good. That's a good sign. So we'll classify the point 2, negative 4. The classifier H is the product of the pure partials at 2, negative 4 minus the product of the mixed partials, but the mixed partials are the same, so we can just square either one of them. So, xx at 2, negative 4 is 2, yy at 2, negative 4 is 1, and then minus negative 4 squared. Well, that's 2 minus 16, so h is negative, and therefore the point 2, negative 4 is a saddle. Okay. A saddle point. Interesting. Okay, so here's another one, but for those of you who like to keep track of the running joke, there's the joke. Haha. So this question is, in fact, exactly like the previous question. So, the critical points. Well, again, the x partial is 3x squared minus 30x plus 48, and the y partial is 6y squared minus 12y minus 18. Those are always defined. That's good. So we want to solve the system 3x squared minus 30x plus 48 equals 0 at the same time as 6y squared minus 12y minus 18 is 0. I'll refer to this as equation 1 and this one as equation 2. So from equation 1, well, we can factor out a 3 to obtain the equation 3x squared minus 10x plus 16 equal to 0. And then that factors as 3 multiplied by x minus 2 times x minus 8 equal to 0. So that's saying that x is 2, where x is 8. So those are the possibilities from equation 1. From equation 2, we can factor out a 6 and obtain 6 y squared minus 2y minus 3. Of course, that factors as well. So 6 times y plus 1 times y minus 3. So the solutions are negative 1 and 3. So we need equation 1 and 2 to be true at the same time, which means that we're going to take all combinations. So that is to say that we have two possibilities, two entire lines where the x partial is 0 at x is 2 and x is 8. So I'll call this the red information. And then the green information y is negative 1, or y is 3. We need a point we need a point points that are red and green. So, well, there's four such points. There is 2, negative 1, 2, 3, 8, negative 1, and 8, 3. Okay, so there's 4 critical points. We need to test them all. So we'll need the second partials. So the second partials test. Okay, so then the xx partial. The xx partial is 6x minus 30. The yy partial is 12y minus 12, the xy partial is 0, and the yx partial also 0. So these are the same. So that's good. Now let's classify each point. So the point 2, negative 1. So again, it's the product of the pure partials. So at 2, negative 1, the xx partial is 12 minus 30, so that's negative 18. And at 2, negative 1, this would be negative 24 minus 0 squared, which is some positive number. Okay, and the xx partial at 2, negative 1 is negative 18, like we said, which is negative. So the combination of the classifier being positive and a pure partial being negative means that the point 2, 1, 2, negative 1, is a max. So that's the classification of the first point. The next point, 2, 3, so here the classifier is, so at 2, 3, the xx partial is again negative 18, the yy partial is now going to be positive 24, and then minus 0 squared, which is negative. So as a result, we can conclude immediately that point 2, 3 is a saddle. The point 8, negative 1 the classifier H. So the xx partial, 6 times 8 is 48, minus 30 is now positive 18. And then the yy partial at negative 1 is negative 24 minus 0 squared. Again, this is a negative value. Therefore, we can conclude immediately that the point 8, negative 1 is a saddle. And the last point, which is 8.3. The classifier here, so the xx partial at 8, 8.3 is 18. The yy partial at 8.3 is 24. Minus 0 squared, that's a positive number. And then we can evaluate the xx partial. Either pure partial would work. So the pure partial at, the pure xx partial at 8.3 is 18, which is positive. So the combination of those two tells us that the point 8.3 is a min. So that's kind of interesting. That means that this one here is a min. Two, negative one, this one down here is a max. And then these other two are saddles. So this is a saddle. And so is this one. Interesting. Okay, so then question 3 is just like question 2 and 1, except now all of the information is given to you and you don't even need to find it. So the classifier is the product of the pure partials minus the product of the mixed partials. And all of that information was given to us. So that's negative 4, negative 3, minus 2 squared. Well, that's 12 minus 4, which is 8, so this is positive. The classifier is positive, and the xx partial at 3, 5 is negative 4, which is negative. And the combination of those two, a positive h and a negative pure partial, tells us that this point, 3, 5, is a max. And then similarly down here, the classifier, the product of the pure partials, 2 and 4, minus the product of the mixed partials, 3 and 3. Well, that's 8 minus 9, so that's negative, so negative. And as a result, the point 4, 1 is a saddle. That's the answer.